burial and resurrection. We thank God he still reigns on the just and non-just. That he no respect the person. Also, we thank God for his goodness that led us to repent. And lead men today to repent and women if they desire to do so. And we thank God he's God all by himself. Everlasting, everlasting, he is God. Besides him, there is no other. We thank God that the word of God is settled in heaven. No adding to it, no taking from it. It's already settled. He said, be holy. It's settled. Be holy. For I am holy. That's the only thing going on in the heaven and the earth.
Amen.
For that new heaven and the earth is going to be holy.
Amen.
It's for holy people.
Amen.
Because the holy God lives there.
Amen.
God's name is holy.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you. We thank God for Jesus.
Amen.
Being obedient to the death of the cross. Because if he hadn't been obedient to the death of the cross, we wouldn't have been redeemed.
Amen.
We wouldn't have a Holy Ghost on today.
Amen.
But it cost him his life and blood to attain what we have today.
Amen.
The precious gift of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Abiding on the inside. We have the evidence by speaking in tongues, and the Spirit of the Holy God give us others. So we thank God. He took time out to have mercy upon us and attain redemption for us through Jesus Christ. Not all this foolishness going on now. We're around holiday, Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
Jesus is the reason for the season. Jesus is the reason I am saved.
Amen.
If you're saved, Jesus read you are saved.
Amen.
If you're not saved, Jesus read that you can be saved.
Amen.
That's right.
Jesus came here to save us from our sin.
Amen.
To obtain eternal life for us.
Right.
Not for us to run around and try to make him minister to sin.
Mm-hmm.
God forbid that.
Amen.
For you said Christ in Christmas. God forbid that.
Amen.
He's not in Christmas.
No, he's not.
He's up there on the right hand of the Father. Making intercession for us.
Yes.
You can't make a mess of sin, try to put him in this foolishness. Like Paul said, I came, I see the whole city giving unto idolatry. The whole country and giving in idolatry. The lights, statues, anything you see, they got all this stuff lying there. We don't know that Jesus ain't no little plastic statue. He ain't no baby. No land, no manger. We know better than that. But that's what they got out there on the arms and everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And the scripture don't make no image of anybody that's in heaven, anything that's in heaven. Well, Jesus in heaven, what you doing about that sin? It's like it was a baby laying on a man. Disobeying God. I got an old man on there, that old false prophet, lying to my, what you gonna get Jesus for Christmas? You can't get Jesus nothing. Now, one thing, the only thing you do is obey what he told you to do. But that's what they want to give obedience. Obeying what he told them to do. But once we give you the Holy Ghost, the only thing we do is present our body as a living sacrifice. Or something which is our reasonable service. We can present that, but we're going to have the Holy Ghost. You got to be born again.
Amen.
Before we try to get Jesus something else, you know what Jesus needs?
Yeah.
God, if I was hungry, I wouldn't tell you. Earth and the Lord and the food thereof.
Right.
Cattle on dollars of hill belong to him.
Right.
All silver gold belong to him.
Yeah.
So what you going to give him? You don't want to give your obedience. Repent like he said to. Be born again in the water spirit like he said to. We don't want to do that. We want to run around with our little trees and our little lights and all this foolishness. We doing something for Jesus. You show me book chapters of what Jesus told you to do that. Show me book chapters of what Jesus was born on December 25th. It ain't in there. The Bible says Psalm 101, 7 says, all liars. No, not Psalm 101, 7 says, a liar won't tear in his son. So you tell a lie. You ain't gonna tear in his sight. The book of Revelation says, all liars shall depart in the lake of fire. You can sing a lie, you can live a lie, you can tell a lie, you can also celebrate a lie. And everybody says, all liars. Whatever the lie may be, you go into the lake of fire for it. Ask people, when was the first birthday celebrated in the Bible? Who was this for? Nobody knows. It was a Pharaoh out in Egypt in the book of Genesis. That's between the first seven birthday celebrating in the book of Scripture. Herod is going on what they had already started in the book of Genesis, where they started down in Egypt. See, we do all this stuff, we don't know where he started at. We don't know where it originated, who did it. But it's in the book. Everything you need to know is right here.
Yeah.
But if you don't study, you don't seek it out, you ain't going to know nothing of what folk tell you. But see, everybody said, well, it was Herod. Because you didn't study, but you studied. And went through the scripture over and over again, you got that. Some folks think they go through the Bible one time, they got everything. You ain't got nothing. You ain't even started yet. This is a continuation thing. The book said, follow on to know the Lord. I mean, you got to follow on doing what you were doing. Some folks ain't read it. Scripture through one time. He said, eat the whole world.
Amen.
He said, bite off it. Go through one time, you ain't doing nothing but took a bite. You ain't ate the whole thing. One person of everything is God Almighty.
Amen.
And God reveals us what he wants us to know. And we thank God for it.
Amen.
We don't want to celebrate a lie. But that's all it is. I had old Jack Harrell at the radio station the other day. He's so stupid. It ain't even funny. He thinks he knows something, don't know nothing. Don't even matter who it goes. You don't even know Jesus.
No, he
don't. He said, you don't celebrate Christmas. I said, I sure don't. He said, yeah. Some man back in 1921, he's supposed to search this out. He's supposed to wrote him a Bible. Showing that when Jesus was born. Oh, he did. Tell me more. He said, well, you know, John was older than Jesus. Yeah, I know that. He said, John was born. He said, Jesus, he was conceived in the month of September. When a baby conceived, he's not born.
Right.
He ain't born until he come out the womb.
That's right.
That's when you call it born.
Right.
But he said he was conceived. I heard that lie before too. You ain't tell me nothing I ain't heard before. There's a difference between conception and birth.
Amen.
A lot different. But they're going to try to use that. He said, he was conceived on December 25th. Where you get that from? I know you didn't get it from God. Because the word is selling him. I know what the scripture is. Angel Gabriel came to Mary in the sixth month. And what people don't realize, that was under the law. And under the law, they was going by the count that God gave Moses out there in the wilderness. And God told Moses, the month Abib is the first month of the year. It began the month, first month of the year to you. And the month Abib was in the spring. It was in April. It's the month Abib, first month of the year. So how could Jesus be born in December? when the angel came in the month of April on our calendar, albeit on the Jewish calendar, calendar was born by it. Now it came then, right on to Jesus in the sun. It's impossible. In the fullness of time, Jesus was born. And that full time, at that 9 months, Jesus was born. Now using our calendar, which would be April, get Jesus. If we use Jewish calendar, we go 9 months, you still ain't gonna get December. It's impossible. What they tell you is a lie. Because people don't know the scripture. They don't read for themselves. They take what their folks preach to them, what their folks say to them, and they believe that. A lot of folks don't even know that there's a Jewish calendar. The only calendar they got is the one that man gave. You got to get the calendar God gave. You find that in Exodus 12 chapter. And God told Moses, first month of the year, this is the beginning of the month. Who began the months? But don't he know when he did?
Yeah.
Don't he know which one he made first?
Yeah.
Even in the book of Genesis, you find the first month. And it wasn't called January either. Yeah. So people want to fight against the truth. They won't believe the truth. Because we've been doing this all up. You've been wrong all your life. You've been deceived all your life. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. But we still want to do the same old stuff. We don't want to change. Trying to make Christ a minister of sin. And God has forbidden that. You can't make Christ over into Christmas. That's idolatry. That's a lie. He's not in that. He ain't getting no glory out of that. If he getting glory out of it, we try to make a Christmas for. How many people say happy birthday, Jesus? Won't be his birthday. What you doing giving a present and getting a present? It ain't your birthday. But they do stuff like that. So why man untold them that lie, and they believe that lie, and they celebrating that lie. Only place to go into the lake of fire. Only thing gonna make us free from all that foolishness is what? Truth. That gonna make us free. He came to free us from the law of sin and death by giving us truth. Sanctified and through thy truth, thy word is truth. You taught her truth is in Jesus. When the Spirit of truth comes to testify of me. But people get mad, they don't tell me that ain't Jesus' birthday. Well, I'm telling you it ain't. Now, not when I tell you, I'll show you. And then you got to argue with that, argue with God. He was the one made that body, got inside that body. So argue with him about it. He the one created the month. Argue with him when the first month is. They would argue with folks because they don't want to believe the truth. Ain't no such trying to slip and tip and do things. God says, I see all, I know all, I hear all.
Amen.
So you're trying to slip around and tip and do that. I know you're doing it.
Amen.
I see you doing it. I hear what you were saying. You ain't getting by on me. Because I know judgment day is coming. And I'm going to judge every man according to their work shall be. I'm going to judge you for being disobedient. Judge you for being idolatry. If you love God, you're going to do exactly what the scripture said to you. If you love him, you'll keep my commandments. Why call me Lord, Lord, do not the things I say? Well, like the old Jack Get a couple of running miles, sit there and listen to them. Terrence, come on. You knew that word, I said, Terrence, you got to learn that folk run their mouths. You know what they know. You try to cut them off, you never learn anything. How can you defeat a person unless you know what he's talking about? Then you got truth to come back. There's some people got their, that's probably mouth too big. They don't know how to hold their peace. Mouth can be swift to hear, but slow to speak. We want to jump on the defense to the hearing, about to hear the conclusion of the whole matter. But we don't want to hear the conclusion of the whole matter. I know you're lying, but I want you to go ahead and finish your lie. Because I got truth. A good way of Jesus was in my conception. What that got to do with it? Ain't no word. The shepherd didn't come there, had no conception. The scripture said come there at a conception. Let them know they're going to find her a babe lying in a manger after he'd been born. And that's what the shepherd found. What you on the folk lawn? You don't see no shepherd. Them both be three wise men. Scripture never said how many wise men it was. It just said wise men. What you doing with three on them? Well, the wise men did not find a babe in a manger. They found a child in the house. Jesus was a young child when he got there. It was the shepherd found a babe in a manger. That was the same night that he was born. And they didn't take him no prayer. They went there to worship him. And just trying to tell me, Jesus' birthday, what you going to get Jesus? Jesus looking for somebody to what, obey him so you can worship God in spirit and in truth. For God ain't going to be in no lie. The improper God a lie. Ain't no way he can accept your lie. Something he won't do. We have to live according to the word of God. We're supposed to be hated. Right. Bible even hated all men for my name's sake. You stand up for the name of Jesus, you stand up for truth, folk gonna hate you. Marvel not that the world hates you. It hated me before you got here. And Paul said, I become your enemy because I tell you the truth. You want to make an enemy out of folk tell them the truth. Especially this time of year. They will get mad. Fat folk, some of my wife folk, they said they won't come part of the congregation. Can't ask something, I let them know, I won't celebrate, ain't no Christmas celebration here. They left that door and ain't been back. But they only way they can celebrate Christmas. I'm telling you the truth before you get here. So you need to go on out that door, go on. Well, you can be an idolatry. But if you want concern about your soul and you want to have eternal life, then you have to stay away too far. Amen. We can't follow the ways of the world. Because the world is the enemy to God. It's God's worst enemy is the world. The white chose us out of the world. Rumors of the world told us, touch not, take not, handle not. All are prepared with the user. So we use what the world does, we're going to perish. We're going to the lake of fire. All that foolish he was talking. I don't know who you think. You must be thinking, talking Wiggins. The other people come there after me. You must think you're talking to him. Y'all agree. Or at least one of you saved. Both of you devils. Don't have no truth in you. So y'all agree. Well, I ain't that foolishness. But I'll let you make a fool out of yourself. I hear what you got to say, but I don't believe not one word. I ain't receive not one word because it's not true. Because I know what the scriptures say. Like I tell you, if you don't get Genesis right, you're going to mess up anyhow. You like people make up all these denominations? They made themselves some months. Made themselves a birthday for Jesus. and can't even get the Passover right. They call it Easter. It's not Easter. It's the Feast of Passover. It started down in Egypt when God told them, slay a lamb, put the blood over the doorpost, or death was going to pass through that night, kill all the firstborn, where he didn't see the blood. So death passed over. That's why they call it the Passover. Because death passed over where he seen the blood. And you have been washed in the blood of Jesus Christ, the second death not going to pass over you. You're going to die that second death and the lake of fire. Only thing going to keep you from dying the second death is what? The blood. You got to be cleansed by the blood of all your sins, all your unrighteousness. Well, like I said, they can't even get that right. And one thing about the Passover, it do not change. It's not on Sunday. The Passover is the first month, which is April, the 14th day. Passover is April the 14th. He said, keep it in his ordinance year by year. Don't you change from April the 14th to something else. Catholic Church got all kinds of dates. All them more. Then time when they had it on Mardi Gras. Then Fat Tuesday. Ash Wednesday. 4 days of that. And the Easter. Really do it on Ash Wednesday because do it on Wednesday and what? They always going to fall on Sunday. But now at break, they don't stay the same day. It changes. But every time you got to go, come on Sunday. It ain't changing from Sunday. But the 14th don't be on Sunday every year. Well, people don't know anything about it. They follow all that foolishness. In idolatry. We're going to tell folks the truth. And Dave said, I swear to my own hurt, but I ain't changing. I ain't tell you nothing, I can't back up with the book of scripture. And Paul said, I'm set for the defense of the gospel. If I preach this gospel, I'll be the defendant with the gospel. With what the word of God say. But people, they're so ignorant, they will not change. They got that spirit of unbelief in them. That spirit of disobedience in them. So they won't believe what the scriptures say. They follow the world. We've been chosen out of the world.
Amen.
We don't follow the world.
Amen.
We put be a light into the world.
Amen.
Showing them the right way. What you don't do. We're holy people. We're peculiar people.